Well, I woke up this morning from a reoccurring dream.
Hello, people. I'm Jabby Kuwait, joined by Iman El Zain. And we're looking at Indian ads have no logic from Slaypoint. So thank you, Slaypoint, for allowing us to react to this. Very, very much appreciated. You guys, help Slaypoint get to 5 million subscribers. They are climbing faster and faster. Every time I do a video from them, it jumps up like another 0.20. And so they're at 4.98 million as of this recording. Please subscribe to their channel. There's a link in the description below of this video where you can watch the original if you feel so inclined, and give that an upvote and give them a subscribe. While you're here, please subscribe here as well. Bell icon, all notifications. Check out the reactions. I'm already doing a closeout. End of video. And give this video an upvote if you could. That would be very, very helpful. Iman.
Hey.
So you said you've watched like an Indian movie at one point, and yeah, you don't remember what it was.
I don't remember, but I definitely have seen Bollywood Indian movies.
Okay, so this is not an Indian film or a trailer for an Indian film.
Okay.
This is an Indian YouTube duo, and they will find things on the internet and make fun of it. That's the easiest way to
love
put it.
Love that.
Yeah, so it's more in the vein of comedy. We're looking at subtitles, just as a reminder to you guys. Mm. And so it kind of, you know, flies by a little bit. If you need me to pause, just tap my leg and I'll pause it.
Okay, cool.
And we can like either rewind and look at it again, or
perfect,
you can just talk about it, whatever you want to do.
Hi guys!
Today we're going to talk about the thing that you can't avoid anywhere. Advertisement. Now you're going to have Facebook videos too, man. And if you gave your phone fake, then after leaving home, you also have to deal with these ads.
Well, she's so right.
After listening to ads, there are two things in your mind. Oppo and Vivo. In both companies.
What pops into your head when you think of ad? What immediately comes to your brain?
Well, Oppo or Vivo. Like, she just said it. That's the only thing I can think of now.
Oh, for me, what comes up? Like, for me, on my Instagram, what usually comes up is, like, film-related stuff.
Yeah.
Or workout-related stuff. But if there's an advertisement, God, like, it's usually food. I think
food.
What we get advertised more than anything is food. Like, McDonald's, Burger King, phone stuff, like AT&T or Verizon, things like that.
I think
that.
Phone stuff.
Yeah.
That was the first thing I was going to say,
So
actually.
Phone stuff here, Oppo or Vivo. But, yeah, I think for us, it's, like, Verizon and Sprint more than anything. AT&T,
yeah.
T-Mobile.
Yeah,
those ones.
I don't get food ads on my Instagram. It'd be
car
more
ads,
like beauty,
yeah,
like things like that.
Anyway, mm-hmm, let's not.
But on TV, yeah.
Companies ne pure India ko ad se bhar rakha. TV, Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, Instagram, ya fir apna browser hi. Har dukan ka shutter, bus stop, billboard, sab jagah inhi ke ads bhare hue hai yaar.
Indian team ke jersey pe bhi ye log ne apna logo dal diya. Unko laga hoga ki har ad mein Ranveer aur Deepika ko selfie lete hue dikhana kafi nahi tha, to match ke dauran bhi hame hi dekh. Aur haan, aise phones ke ad mein sirf ek hi cheez ke bare mein baat hoti hai.
Selfie.
Hame selfie to leni hoti hai. Acha processor, acha display, acha software. Ye sab to sirf bahar wale dekhte hai yaar. Hame to sirf ye karna aata hai. Hum selfie sthan mein jo rehte hain. सॉरी मैं थोड़ा टेक्निकल गुरुजी जैसा साउंड करने लग गया।
सेल्फी खिंचवानी है तो डेफिनेटली भाई करना तो पड़ता है ना। दोस्तों चलिए खिलाड़ी वीडियो में निकल कर
What the hell is
this? Oh my god! I was like, what's M&M mode? And that was great.
इस ऐड के वजह से अगर आजकल कोई भी अपने WhatsApp ग्रुप पे क्या चल रहा है लिखता है ना, तो एक बंदा जरूर होगा जो ये लिखकर रिप्लाई करेगा।
Oh, I don't get this joke.
Or fairness creams. तरक्की करने के लिए कितने अच्छे अच्छे
fairness creams.
Okay, so fairness creams. It's the effort to look like you. Fairness creams make your skin,
oh,
if you're darker.
I know. Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
heard,
you,
yeah,
it
yeah,
makes
yeah,
you
yeah,
look. Well, you actually look kind of tanner than when I first met you, but. We met at a taco shop. All I saw was this right here because she had her mask on. So
also, it was, you know, what, like a month ago? So
yeah.
Summer, I've gotten more sun.
Yeah, there you go. So you've been out at the beach. But yeah, generally speaking, I mean, fairness creams is what is used
yeah,
to lighten your skin.
Mm-hmm.
This is prevalent throughout Asia in general.
Mm-hmm.
But I guess in India, it's really a thing. This is a technical thing. It's not really what the video is talking about, but I wanted to mention it. The selfie cam is the worst camera on your phone. Mm-hmm. Like, generally speaking, this has four lenses, okay? 1, 2, 3, 4. This is the worst one.
Yeah.
It's the absolute worst one. And mm-hmm, it's the one that is used the most. And it's so strange to me that Apple refuses. I mean, they don't put a thing on the back for selfies like that. And they have cameras that are coming out with phones that are coming
they
out with
should
the,
do that.
Yeah,
just a little mirror.
Just to use, yeah, something so that you can kind of get a gauge. Like even the stupid little Polaroid cameras.
I was going to say, I have a Polaroid and it has one of those little tiny little mirror things. And it doesn't take any more room than like my little crystals
exactly
on the phone. And like they could just do that and then you could take selfies.
Exactly. That's just about the technical side of things. With regards to the selfie itself, it's such an odd generation that we live in. It's a very is vapid the right word or is it just vain? Mm-hmm. I think vain is the right word. We're just a very vain. And, and the thing is, it's by necessity in order to participate because the fact of the matter is we're not always with each other, especially in these times. Mm-hmm. Even before Corona, even before the lockdown and whatnot.
We were already moving that direction.
We were well into that direction where it's like we're all at home on our phones pointed at ourselves. It's sad.
तरक्की करने के लिए कितने अच्छे अच्छे चीजें सीखने मिलती है ना हमें. YouTube बोलता है कि नींबू में लौंग लगा दो और टीवी पे बोलता है बस गोरे हो जाओ, क्योंकि यही तो एक तरीका है जिससे हम लड़कियां लड़कों की बराबरी कर सकती है. और लड़कों को सब कुछ मिलने के बाद भी अगर एक अच्छी गर्लफ्रेंड नहीं मिल रही हो ना, तो 200 रुपए का कोई वीडियो लगा लो और हो गया काम.
Hold on, I just want to back up a little bit.
My chocolate boy.
My brain went somewhere else for a second. What I realized was I wanted to compliment Slay Point real quick. This is a fairly new video, I believe. Let me make sure. Yeah. No, this is from 2017. Okay.
Oh.
So, Slay Point, if you're watching this, I'm thoroughly enjoying the pace of this video. I'm used to their newer ones that move at such a clip. Because I set you up wrong. I was like, it moves fast. So if you need to pause it or whatever, just let me know.
Right.
It's moving at a really nice pace, which I appreciate. And I'm sure the Indian audience is like, God, this is slow as shit. But for me, it's like, this is a perfect pace because I can keep up with it and process it and laugh and all that stuff.
It allows for our commentary.
Exactly.
बट एज अ गर्ल मैं आपको एक सीक्रेट बताऊं, सिर्फ एक डीओ लगाने से लड़कियां नहीं पड़ती.
तो इंडियन आर्ट्स में आप लॉजिक एक्सपेक्ट नहीं कर सकते. स्पेशली
how far does a deodorant or a spray go for you? Let's say that you're in a room, right, and at an audition or something, and a guy walks in and he looks kind of like a schlep, a schlemiel, a putz, if you will, you know, take a schmuck, like golly. But then he smells fantastic. If he's at a one, based on what I just assessed for you, where does the smell take him to?
So I did a soap commercial once and the whole thing was like, guys, if you don't smell right, then I'm not interested. So I think I'm kind of obligated to say that, yeah, if you smell right, that's what does it.
Okay. All right, then. There you go.
But it's got to be the right smell. Don't get the drugstore deodorant or body wash. You know, you got to get the, like, the good stuff.
You got to find the thing that works for your chemistry, because everybody's chemistry is different. I dated a girl once who wore men's cologne. I'm like, why would you do that? She goes, because when it enters my chemistry, it smells fruity. I was like, what are you? And I smelled it and I was like, oh, wow, like it does smell like perfume. So it's just strange. Like, it's just chemistry.
So Indian ads, you can't expect logic. Especially in ads, where we are Salman brothers. Let's see what this is.
Okay, Salman Khan is a very, very big star in India, just so you know. Like, one of the biggest.
Okay.
Yeah.
And he's in a lot of ads.
As soon as I said that. Okay, I already know what some people are going to say in the comments. He's a really, really big star in the world, but in India, he's very, very, very big.
Especially in ads mein jisme hamare Salman bhai ho. Chalo ye wala dekhte hai kya hai.
Maine suna hai ye log skirt ke andar kuch nahi pehante.
Ta jaanch padtal karte hain.
Is pe jaanch padtal? Bhai aise doubts kisko aate hain? Chalo bhai ka doubt tha to ek baar ke liye maan lete hain. Chalo aage. Theek hai, inme gaane ka competition chal raha hai. To Salman bhai gaane hi baja raha hai aajkal. To ye log pehante hain. Par iska Dixie Scott se kya lena dena?
That's hilarious.
Lekin hamari tarah Dixie Scott नहीं पहनते Dixie Scott.
क्या था ये?
Look, the ads don't need to be sensible. They need to be memorable. That is the objective. I've seen a lot of ads. I've participated in a lot of ads as a commercial actor, as a session runner for commercial casting. I've seen a lot of things. The way I met...
Oh my God, you must have seen so many things.
I've told the story already. There's a video dedicated to it, but the short version is when I met Achara, the ad was for Orangina, and it was about a huge pigeon taking a massive dump on the girl walking. Did you do that audition?
Sounds brilliant, masterful cinema. No, I sadly missed that audition.
No, yeah, so this was years ago. And that's how I met Achara, was like in this ad where a huge pigeon takes a dump on her, and that was it. And I'm like, this is so absurd. Oh, and like, ads have only gotten progressively more absurd.
More absurd.
So
can't hate on them for that. We like the absurdity.
This was actually fine as far as I go. But like, I get it. It's stupid as hell. But the absurdity is part of commercials because it's all about getting your attention.
They need people talking about it.
Our very own.
Do you know him too?
He's a big star.
Okay.
स्पोर्ट बनाने लायक एक खेल का निर्माण किया है. लॉर्ड तेरी गर्लफ्रेंड पड़ी है पीछे पर हम स्ट्रिक्ट विद द ब्रो को पीछे पर हम
तो तो ये तो हो गए एड्स जो हमें रेगुलरली टीवी पे दिख जाते हैं, पर ऐसे भी कुछ क्रिएटिव और इनोवेटिव एड्स हैं जो हमारे सामने आने से पहले ही चल बसते हैं। जैसे ये वाला टप्पा टप डिटर्जेंट साबुन।
हाय प्रिया, हाय नहीं टप्पा टप।
Oh, is she telling her she smells bad?
I don't know.
It's like you need this deodorant soap.
License me! It
smells bad too.
Look, we get Mentos ads over here that are equally asinine.
100%.
I was going to say the R word, but there was one where, I'm sure some of you guys have seen it, where this dude was, he sat on a bench in his brand new suit, like he's getting ready for an office something or another, and the bench was freshly painted, and you see the painter look at him go, and he holds his roller up. It's like all no dialogue, right? And he goes, oh my God. Takes out a Mentos, eats the Mentos. He goes, I got an idea. And he starts laying on it in these different angles and whatnot. Now he's got a striped suit. I'm like, all right.
Brilliant.
So, brilliant. You know, that's just ads, you know?
They're their own kind of art.
Exactly.
License me. Tapata.
Tapata. Tapata.
दोस्त ने हाय बोला तो टप्पा टप, पुलिस वाले ने लाइसेंस मांगा तो उसे टप्पा टप बोल के डिटर्जेंट साबुन पकड़ा के चले जाते हैं। भाई लॉजिक क्या है? सबके लिए साबुन लेके घूमते हैं ये दोनों, और वो भी गिफ्ट।
Yeah, it's gift wrapped. You can't even see the logo.
जब आपका दोस्त आपको हाय बोले तो आपको क्या करना?
टप्पा टप,
टप्पा टप,
टप्पा टप,
you're saying it.
टप्पा टप।
आप दोनों वीडियो देख रहे हैं ना, तो मेरे पास आपके लिए एक सवाल था, क्या आप दोनों यहाँ पागल खाने से भाग रहे
हैं? हीरो आलोम, सही में यार ये बंदा तो बिल्कुल हीरो आलोम जैसा लगता है।
What is happening?
खुदा ने जब तुझे बनाया होगा।
ओह
यू वाह, कैसे लगा
है? तुमने क्या देखा है छे? तुम्हें मैसेज आ
मत। Wow. I'm like too stunned to
A Singham. Singham's a big action film.
Oh, and he gets on the back.
Yeah. Hey, you know,
भाई तो
progressive.
अपने बाइक से उतरकर लड़की के स्कूटर पे बैठकर आई चेकअप कराने जा रहा है। कोई पोल नहीं उखाड़ा है तूने जो ये सिंगम वाला बैकग्राउंड म्यूजिक लगाया पीछे।
This is really
bad. हाय क्या स्माइल, यही तो कमी है यार आजकल के लड़कों में।
मैं आपको फोन कर।
ये कैसा एक्सप्रेशन है?
Oh no.
I'm sure you've seen that expression.
Probably a time or two. I do the same thing. I have the same reaction.
Let me tell you what that expression is. That expression is, oh my God, she's pretty. Oh my God, she's looking at me. Oh my God, she realizes I'm staring at her. Oh my God, how do I undo this? Like, oops,
that's
I was caught.
That's the best explanation I've ever gotten for that.
It's just like, the thing about it is you're looking at someone in your brain, you're going, damn, she's fine. Damn it, she's looking at me. Oh my God, I must be a creep. I must look like a creep. I'm not a creep though. It's like all these thoughts run through your head, and it's like your eyes, your body is on autopilot at that point. Mm-hmm. Your thoughts are the only thing you're kind of aware of, but you're so lost in that other state of mind, you've sort of done this outer body experience in
so
a way.
So you've got all of those thoughts, and the girl has one thought, and that's, ugh.
Yes. Yes. Exactly. Look, I'm gonna be real with you guys. I get hit on a lot by dudes, okay?
Aww.
They for some reason,
good for you.
Their radar, the gaydar of men in this city
goes off.
It gets really screwy around me. They don't know what to do with me, and it's because of how I dress, it's how I carry myself, and I guess it's the pseudo metro vibe off. And so guys think that
you take care of yourself and suddenly you're not a straight man or something.
Whatever they want to think. It's like I've had the stare of I'm going to f- you. Like
so you've been on the receiving end.
Oh no, totally. I've been there. And the thing about it is, at least with you, at least with girls, guys go,
oh shit.
And they give you that awkward look.
Yeah.
With me, it's just
and they just dial in.
Yeah, they're just waiting until we're gonna. That's
they're looking to receive it back.
Yes, exactly. And I don't. I just kind of go. Oh my God! Stop it! Stop! It's super awkward. And so, but I totally get the towel feeling here. There's no way to recover.
No.
That's the sad thing. Because like, let's say I met you somewhere and I was staring, and then I was like, right, and then you're like, God, what a creep. And I come up to you afterwards. I go, hey. I apologize. I'm so sorry about like staring. I just thought you were really pretty. I lost control of my function for a second. I apologize. That's just going to make it worse. There's nothing you can say to make it better.
I think communication is important. You can be like, oh wow, I'm so sorry. Like, you were in my eye. Like, you can communicate.
Yeah.
You know, I'm always a big fan of that.
Yeah.
It's true. She may still look at you like a creep and walk away.
I got a good one. Here's what you can do. Sorry for staring. Like, there's this like old friend of mine who was really close to me, and she died like 5 years ago, and I so thought you were her. That would totally recover you.
I'm so sorry to hear that. Wow. Are you okay?
Exactly. Like, that's actually a really good. I just came up with that. That would work.
You came up with that now? You haven't used that in the past?
No. I never use lines.
That might work.
Yeah.
I don't usually go for lines, but that might work.
All right, here we go. Save me. Oh, God. This is very...
Oh, no. Yeah, report this.
That's terrible. So stupid. That is terrible.
What?
That is terrible.
What?
Please save me. We're not trying to. Are you? I can't say the R word. We're not trying to.
Oh my God.
Rip your clothes off and take advantage of you. We're just trying to find out what phone you use.
Wow. Koopa Mobile.
I can't believe that's the ad. Oh,
and then
God.
She was just like happy to share. Well, I guess when you find out that they're not going to do that other thing, you're just happy to share where your phone is from. You're like, yeah.
But when you walk away today, that's the ad you're going to remember.
It is. That's true. Sadly. Very sadly.
इनका एक और ऐड है जिसमें ये आपको कमाल का मैजिक दिखाएंगे.
Oh boy. Wow. Is that the same guy from before?
It looks like it. Big TV
Hathway. ये है टाटा स्काई डिस्क. ये यहां कर क्या रहा है?
सेल्स एंड सर्विस में. यहां पर डिश के रिचार्ज कार्ड दे
देते हैं. I love the subtitle.
Lots of ad stuff.
Please ye mat bolna ki yahan pe SRK ki mimicry karne ki koshish ki ja rahi hai. Please nahi. Aur ye jo
Okay, SRK, sorry. I sometimes forget what you don't know. So SRK is a huge Indian star. The guy you saw earlier, Salman Khan, SRK it stands for Shah Rukh Khan. They're both like really, really, really huge Bollywood stars.
Proprietor Imran Khan ki yahan baat ho rahi hai.
Proprietor Imran Khan.
उन्हें इन सब से कोई लेना देना नहीं है, कोई इंटरेस्ट नहीं. उन्हीं की दुकान का एड बन रहा है और उन्हीं को कोई इंटरेस्ट नहीं है, क्योंकि शायद उन्हें भी पता है कि अंत में इसके एडिटिंग तो एक 10 साल का बच्चा ही करने वाला है. एडिटिंग इफेक्ट सब एकदम कमाल.
ये है जहां सुकड़ा का फेमस प्रेम प्रकाश बिस्कुट से शुद्ध घी में डाल के बनाया गया.
वाओ, व्हाट इफेक्ट्स.
तो ये है बिस्कुट, प्रेम प्रकाश बिस्कुट.
काफी बकवास चीजों के बारे में बात कर ली. अब मुझे कुछ अनाउंस करना है. हम एक और Q&A करने वाले हैं और आपको अपने सारे क्वेश्चंस हमें हमारे इंस्टाग्राम ऑप्शन में है और क्वेश्चन.
And we'll see you guys in the next one.
How'd you feel about that? That was fun.
Wow, I gotta like recenter myself after that. Yeah. That was a lot.
Yeah. I mean, here's the thing. Some of those ads were extremely cringe, I'm not gonna lie. But you know, if you ever turned on like cable, like just cable in general.
I don't have cable anymore.
Well, I used to. I don't either. I haven't had proper TV in about 11 years, I think. Every time I've seen cable at a friend's house, at a girlfriend's house, at a relative's house.
It's cringy.
There's a lot of cringy ads like that are like really, do you ever see the ad, Jack Steffen. You never seen that?
No.
We're in the white pages. It's like, this is like a really, really old ad that I saw as a kid. I'm like, golly, this is dumb. This is not Indian ads. This is
ads
globally.
In general.
Yeah, globally, you're going to get the gamut of stupidity, right? Sometimes you don't. Sometimes you get cool ads.
Yeah, once in a while.
But a lot of times it's just silly, and it's just to like quickly get your attention. Oftentimes they're louder than the show that you're watching. I've been watching Superman and Lois lately, and in between, there's a bunch of ads, and I'm like, who, what? And I'm just like, I'm so confused the entire time. Like, why would you? And it's the maximum ridiculousness possible.
Yeah, which is the whole point, right? Yep. So they're doing something right.
Some of the really low rent ads that they were showing, I'm like, Oh God. Like the one with Cuba when was it called Cuba?
Cuba Mobile.
Where they chased the girl down?
Yeah, that one was a little bit. I was like, like sometimes you can just pass it off as it's an ad being an ad, but that was maybe somebody should have rethought that one.
There's a word I can't use, so I'm going to use a G in front of it. That was a little grapey.
Oh yeah, no, it was very grapey.
It was extremely grapey.
I think that was very clear. Yes.
Some woman is running, afraid of getting graped. And I can't believe I haven't come up with this sooner. You have any idea how many times I've had to bleep out the R word? Grape.
I knew not to use it in the last video.
Oh, very good.
I was like, what do I say instead? Yeah, I wish I had thought of grape. Yeah, that would have been great.
Grapes. Okay, so grape. There is the, what a really, really bad subject to go to.
It was an ad that needed some more rethinking, I think. But it was the one we remembered.
Yeah.
It was the one we remembered.
I mean, here's the thing. I want to know from the females in the audience, how did you feel about that ad? Did it make you go offended, hashtag? Or were you like, that's kind of funny? You know, because I'm of the mindset that like, you might still be able to make me laugh even with a really, really messed up joke. Mm-hmm. That one in particular is obviously in poor taste, but I still got a chuckle out of it. I would not personally do it myself, but I got a chuckle out of it.
But like if you got a chuckle out of it because you were watching it in a format that was like, oh wow, this is bad. But if you were like just sitting watching TV and you saw that ad, would you have gotten the same chuckle? Or would you have been like,
see, everything is context,
what did I
right?
just watch?
Everything is context, because it's like if I'm watching a Darren Aronofsky film and the same situation happens and afterwards the guy's like, I'm not trying to grape, I am just asking what kind of phone you have, I'm gonna be like, that was terrible. But if it's like, if it's something like in the vein of Jackass or I can't think of a comedy guy right now who did Knocked Up. Like if it was like that, then maybe I would laugh.
Context is everything.
Yeah, context is everything. Mm-hmm. And that's important. And in this particular case, it was obviously extremely lo-fi. So it's like, come on. Poor taste, but come on. And the other ones I can't, the smell thing.
Oh, yeah.
The smell thing goes a long...
The tap-tap. Wait.
Tap-tap. Yeah, tap-a-tap.
Tap-a-tap.
The smell thing goes a long way. And I'll tell you why. There was a girl I was interested... I was sort of dating, short-term. And I was like, maybe not. Maybe this is the end of the road. But like, she smelled so good. It actually extended another week. You get a whole extra week out of me.
Oh, a whole extra week.
Yeah, because she smelled good. It was a two-week thing.
So it doubled her time with you.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, you know, smell does go a long way.
Yeah. I'm not going to say that... Like, okay, when my guy smells like,
conversely, smell can immediately do something.
That is true.
You
smell
know?
Can repel you.
Yeah.
That is probably more true than me. Like, yeah, I like the smells, but I'm not, like the situation you gave of the guy like walking into the audition room, it would have to be a really insanely good smell, and I can't picture what that would be. But if he was just a little bit bad, if he was even just a little bit smelling bad, I would be gone.
Right. No, exactly. Like there have been instances where I was like talking to someone, I was flirting, and then I smelled their breath or something.
Ooh.
And I was just like, oh my God, did like a...
Do you want a tap-a-tap?
Yeah, I did. Did a squirrel die in your throat? Like, what happened there?
Oh,
you know, did you brush your teeth with dog shit? Like, why does it smell like that? And the worst is when you're dating someone that you're actually interested in, and that's when you catch it, and you say something, and they're like, no one's complained before. That's the worst. That's the worst thing to hear is whenever a partner tells you that. No one's ever complained before. It's like, well, I am.
That sounds like a terrible retort. If somebody said that to me, I'd be like, I'm so sorry. Let me go brush my teeth and like figure out some Tic Tacs, you know, but not just no one's complained.
Tap it, tap.
Tap it, tap.
You guys, thanks so much for hanging out. Hopefully you enjoyed that. Thank you, Slate Point, for allowing us to react to this.
Thank
very much
you.
Appreciate it. If you guys haven't already, subscribe to Slate Point. Again, there's a link in the description below. If you scroll down, check out our other reactions, reviews, short films, vlogs, and interviews. I'm Jabby Kuwait. This is...
I'm Iman El Zain.
Peace
Thank
out.
You.